with you. It's going to feel like spring this week. Woo! Is that good or bad? Okay. just checking. Hey, there's attendance pads in the row that you're sitting in. Please fill that out. Let us know that you were here. If there's not one in your row, look behind you. I don't know. Look in front of you. Share it with people. There's also prayer cards in the seat backs in front of you. Count it a privilege to be able to pray with you and for you. You can drop that in the offering baskets near the end of our worship. So today we're wrapping up this series on the power of words. We've been looking at some different words that the Bible highlights and that, well, frankly, are good for our lives. And today is that word that we seem to be really good at it when we're little, but we're not very good at it when we grow up. It's two letters. No. Are you good at saying no?
Right there. Oh.
Yes, it is, and yes, you are. You know, we don't like being told what to do when we're little, so we'd say no. Some of us, when we grow up, don't like being told what to do. But saying no has a lot more to do with, well, creating boundaries around our lives. So at the beginning of this year, I started saying no to some things because my birthday's in the middle of January, so I always do the annual physical, and this year the blood work, one of the numbers came back a little higher than, and Doc and I are looking at each other like, wonder what that's about. So we made a plan, and so I started saying no to so much sugar, really paying attention to how much sugar, because the last part of 2017, I didn't pay much attention to the sugar thing, and we agreed little more consistent on the exercise. You know, I talk about that all the time, and you'd think, the last half of 2017 was not very consistent. And then the third thing we came up with was saying no to so many carbs. I mean, he's told me for years, the doctor has, that your body will create all that it needs on its own. You don't. So I've really cut down on the bread. I love bread. Oh, cut down on bread, you know, baked goods, potatoes. Oh, man. Got to say no to some things. I'm hungry. No. and so I've noticed over just 6 weeks, more energy. Well, it wasn't really what I was going for, but more energy. I'm not as tired. I'm not as sore even when I'm working out. I'm like, well, these are some nice benefits on the side of that. Now, yesterday, Stephanie went to what was hopefully her last swim meet ever until her grandkids maybe swim because our son... when you love your son and your son loves a girl, and the girl says, are your parents going to be at my last meet? Aww. Of course we are. And so we were in Akron yesterday, and we were at Maggie's parents' house in between because they live in Akron, and they had sandwiches and Pepsi.
Pie.
And pie. Completely destroyed everything yesterday. So I'm back at it today. What do you have to say no to in your life? We're going to look at some things. There are some people you cannot say no to. Jessica, sorry. Still doesn't mean we give everybody everything they say they want. No is a great word. Jesus said it. He calls us to say it too. Let's stand, greet somebody around you, and we'll sing a little bit.